time. The Supreme Board of General Command, Superboy Commander and General Manager of VWE, Scarmon.
You know, production scene number 4506 is getting fired. The General Manager's music is not playing.
It is playing. What are you talking about?
It says this video is unavailable.
What the hell is he doing? This is VWE, not Dance Revolution. It's definitely not so you think you can dance either.
Well, at least he's not twerking.
Don't give him ideas.
We want to see twerking.
No, we don't. Shut up.
All right. First off. Thank you, everybody, so much for the warm reception. Oh, I'm actually not used to this. Thank you so much. All right. But anyways, I'm here to get down to business. And I believe that you all, let's address the elephant in the room. Because you know what? I think, I just got to say, it's so heartbreaking what has been going down between Morgan Jones and Brakman Wylder. I mean, trust me, I did not want them to turn on each other like this. You know, you think I wanted that hell? No, that was my money in the bank. That was a dream team. You know, I could have marketed that to hell and back. I could have made millions, literally millions for this company. But, you know, they had to go and muck it up. So I've arranged for security to bring them both out here tonight, and sit their asses down in these chairs so Daddy D can settle the dispute and get everybody back on the same page working together. Now, with that said, Security Steve, Security Steven, and Security Stefan, please bring out Morgan Jones and Brakman Wylder.
All right, so more clones of Steve.
He's got to be joking, right?
No. Look, there's Steve and Steven bringing out Brakman. And there's production Stevie Wonder, the blind one, bringing out Morgan Jones.
Oh, my God. I don't know how well this is going to turn out.
Mr. Wylder, thank you for joining us. Mr. Jones, good to see that you are being cooperative as well. All right, and can I get security to line up? Let's just form a nice wall of friendship here. Yep, there we go. Let's just make sure that there's a nice wall of security to make sure that this all goes off without a hitch. All right. Now, before I let either of you speak, and trust me, you will get a chance to speak, and I won't give you a chance to let your tempers get the better of yourselves. Allow me to lay down some facts that might get you both to realize that you both actually have a lot more in common, and that you might even know. And in spite of everything that has happened, just how silly that you're both being about all this. I mean, Brakman Wylder, Brak. I mean, come on. All of this over
D.
A beard. Mine grew in between now and the start of the show, so relax. Beards grow back, but you can't regrow a broken friendship. And speaking of which, Morgan Jones, deep down, you don't really want to be without a single friend, do you? I know you miss Bionic Chronic. I know you do. I know you really do. But come on. Taking it out on Brak? No, that isn't the way to go, man. And Brak.
D. I told you to stop. Listen. Now, I'm not destroying Morgan right now out of respect for the sport of wrestling. But that only goes so far. You see, Morgan, he stabbed me in the back. He stabbed his team in the back. He stabbed us in the front, in the side, and on top. He is a snake who breaks a skateboard over someone's head, Morgan. Who does that? Morgan Jones does. Who shaves someone else's beard off? Morgan Jones does. And worst of all, who attacks and threatens a ref like he did 2 weeks ago? That little Judas, Morgan Jones does.
Oh, why don't you just stop? Why don't you stop lying to everybody, Brakman? And most importantly, stop lying to yourself. Man, last week it was cute. It was endearing. You came out here and you wore your shame on your face, and you came out to the ring and quite frankly, you sold your ass off. And look, I'm impressed. Some people bought it. You still have fans, right? You got cheered when you came out here. You still have fans. But why don't we really get down to it, Brakman? You told everybody about how I freed you and that you're still Brakman Wylder and fuck Morgan Jones. But I mean, come on. After I shaved that beard off of your face, you should have never come back. And you know why? Because Brakman Wylder is nothing without the beard. I mean, it is literally the only thing that people recognize you for, right? The beard, Brakman Wylder, all of your merchandise says the beard. And you come out here and you stroke your beard. And I mean, for Christ's sakes, even your merchandise, your maneuver is called the Bearded Dragon. It's all you have. So what exactly did I free you from, Brakman? Perhaps the only thing that makes you relevant?
Uh-oh.
D, get these clowns out of here. And let's settle this right now, Morgan. I want this fight.
Do you want to know the difference between you and I, Brakman?
Oh, no.
Do you want to know the difference between you and I? I know exactly who I am. And the reason why I'm so well known is because if you really know your shit when it comes down to it, I am one of the greatest innovators in this thing that we do. That is what I am known for. I am known as Morgan Jones, period. There is no catch. There is no moniker. I don't need anything to speak for me. And so when you go home and look your family in the face, I hope you know, and I hope that they know that you, your whole career, you have been nothing but a novelty. You are nothing. You are nothing like me. You are nothing without your beard.
Oh, dear.
I sit in a dark room and I think bad thoughts, Morgan, of how I'm gonna beat you. You used to be my friend. And now, I can't wait.
Uh-oh. Oh, no. Oh, no.
Oh, no. Oh, look at this. Brakman goes after Morgan, and security Steve, Stevie, and Steven have to hold him back.
Fight!
Oh, Jesus. This is about what as well as pouring gasoline on a fire.
Oh, yeah. As someone said in the audience, not enough Steves in there to stop Brakman.
Yeah, you can tell he is pissed. Oh yeah, he's pissed.